I'm Micah Smith, and in this video, we're going to take a look at what are the different types of bots organizations are creating and what those bots are actually capable of. Now, with Valentine's Day coming up, we decided to do a special video that we're going to be calling The Bachelor. So if you're not familiar, The Bachelor is a popular show in the U.S. as well as other countries where there's one person and then they like have all these other people come and date them, and then they end up picking one and they pick their favorite. So we're going to do the same thing. We're going to look at a couple different types of bots that organizations are having success with in their RPA practice. And we're going to look at the foundation of what those bots are, what those bots are capable of, and also why those bots are important. And if you're not exploring all different types of bots in your bot builds, I'd encourage you to look at some of those. And some of them we have good videos for that you can follow up on to create your own. Sound good? Cool. So let's get right into it. What's your type, right? We're going to look at four different types of bots, and we're going to talk about what's important for each of them, the pros and the cons, and then I'll talk about some of my favorites. So the first type of bot that I think of is the stuff we're doing today bot. And I know that doesn't really roll off the tongue, but this is the kind of bots that usually drive people to investigate RPA and get into automation anywhere in the first place, right? They're looking to automate those tasks that are done every single day, where humans are really playing the role of, you know, kind of glue in between different applications. And what I mean by that is, you know, as different leaders come into an organization, they might have a favorite workflow application that they use, or a favorite content management system they like, or a CRM tool that they really are comfortable with. And organizations start to basically create all of this technical debt because they don't always retire the older platforms. They just bring new ones in and new ones in and new ones in. And so what's happening is that humans end up having to be the glue in between some of those applications that don't always talk well to each other, right? Either they don't have an API at all, or their API is totally lacking and there's no real way to get that data out. And so those type of bots are the ones that are basically allowing us to take the humans out of those processes where they're just being glue to hold applications together and move data from one place to another, and have the bot take care of that kind of task. And so it's the very robotic, repetitive tasks that bots are able to help out with. And so that includes stuff like moving data from one application to another, doing some really basic data validations as we move from system to system. It includes moving data out of one app, validating it, and then putting it into another app. Maybe that's for a support of a migration or helpful in the retirement of another application. So those are what I would call kind of the bread and butter bots. They're the ones that typically have the highest ROI, and they're the ones that a lot of organizations focus on first, because for them, that's that like low-hanging fruit. Those are the ones that you get the most bang for your buck out of. The next type of bot that I would say that a lot of organizations are exploring are the stuff we should be doing bots. And again, another kind of poorly named bot. But the reality is, these are the kind of bots that are the tasks that we should be doing, but we're not doing. And we all have those, right? What are the things that I should be doing every week that I'm not actually doing every week? And at an organizational level, that can look like running long-running reports more frequently, right? If a bot is able to start that long-running report at, let's say, 2 a.m., it can be done by 8 a.m. by the time that this leader comes into the organization. They're able to have that report more frequently than if someone had to queue up that work and actually start and run the report and it spent their entire day doing it. And so the stuff we should be doing bots help us to do things like run reconciliation reports, right? I want to see how often work is coming into my organization and how often that work is leaving, especially if it's a customer transaction. I want to be able to see, did I meet my SLA, right? And I want to run those kind of reports much more frequently than many organizations already do. If you're running that at a quarterly basis just to see if you met your SLAs, you're probably not doing yourself a service. I want to have more close to real-time reporting so that I can identify where those bottlenecks are, and so that I can step in to resolve those kind of issues, either with human augmentation or with bot augmentation, to make sure that we can identify those process gaps and have something take care of it, ideally a bot or a humans that we can have help out with that process. But the stuff we should be doing today, bots, is really just understanding what are the things that, you know, it would be great if we had this more frequently. Like I said, the reconciliation reports, the reports on the productivity of our staff and the productivity of our systems. What are the kind of things that we should be doing? Proactive system checks is another one that I think of, right? That's something we should be doing. We're not always great at doing it, but if I can identify issues in my application before my customer does, which again, my customer could be an actual paying customer, or it could be another team internally that's using an app that I'm hosting. I want to be able to identify those so that I can create a good customer experience. And I want to identify those issues so that I can fix those either automated or manually before my customer is the one to tell me about the problem. Okay, so that's an example of some of the stuff we should be doing bots. The next category that I think of is data manipulation bots. And this is where we start to get to bots that are a little bit more creative and less about what are the work and what are the tasks that we're doing already, but what could we do and what could we explore if we're able to use bots to pull data together. A good example of this, if you're a single family real estate investor, a common back of the napkin math to say, is this a good investment property or not, is to say that if I buy a house, let's say I buy it for $100,000, I should expect that I get 1% of that total purchase price back in rent every single month. So if I bought a $100,000 house and I'm not getting $1,000 a month in rent, that's probably not a good investment opportunity for me. The problem is that if I go to Zillow or if I go to realtor.com, I can find all of the property listings for a particular area, but they don't have rental estimates. So I don't know what any of these homes would rent for. I do know what homes are available for sale. There are other applications that have the rental estimates for particular homes or in particular zip codes, but I don't necessarily have those tied together with all of the rental properties. And so what we'd want to do is have a bot that could go grab all of the data from this, you know, realtor.com or Zillow, and then also look up all of the rental estimates so I can quickly come up with a list of what are the homes that meet my criteria. If that's the 1% rule where the rent looks like it's 1% or greater of the total purchase price, that's a kind of situation where I'm using a bot to grab data from two disparate systems to put that together so that I can more easily make decisions. And again, this is where leaders are going to be using bots to make better data-driven decisions. If you're not basing your decisions off of data, then you're really kind of, you know, I think the saying goes like flying by the seat of your pants. And so it's creatively thinking about how can I put data together in different ways to better drive my business decisions. The last bot that we'll talk about here is the cognitive automation bots. And this is where we're going beyond just that repetitive rule-based automation, but starting to build some level of intelligence into our processes. And that might mean including IQ bot in your process to do intelligent data extraction or invoice extraction. It might mean consuming services from AWS or Azure or Google to use their cognitive APIs. It might mean building your own. And so with cognitive automation, what we're looking to do is take some of that intelligence and build that into our bots so our bots can start to make decisions on their own instead of just being very much rule-based, task-driven automation. We're starting to include some of that intelligence. My big thing here is just to make sure you're using it with guardrails. If I'm a mortgage company and usually we're doing loans for $100,000 to $300,000 and all of a sudden we get a $10 million loan, I don't want the bot to automatically approve that one because it matches the criteria of our, you know, machine learning model for mortgage approval. I want to make sure I have some safeguards in place to make sure that, hey, if something is way out of range, that it's identified and it can be manually reviewed. So as far as picking a favorite type, I can't, right? I like all of these types of bots. I think there's a use for all of them. Through the discussion that we just had and the different descriptions of the bot types, there's definitely a place for all of those bots to exist. If you're not exploring all of these different bot types right now, I would strongly encourage you to start thinking more creatively about different ways that you can take on automations within your organization. So now that we've seen all the different types of bots, what are your favorite types? Which one do you make? Which one do you connect with the most? Let us know on social, vote. We've got numbers on each of these, so make sure to put a number in. If you've got a totally different type of bot that you like to create, put number 5 and let us know what that is. Thanks again for watching. Happy Valentine's Day. I'm Micah Smith. Go be great.